Hey, beautiful people. Today, we have a very educative video for you. And the person who is going to introduce this video is no other person else than my charismatic leader, Dan Ter, our class leader. So he's the main coordinator in this CSI class. So let's go.
Thank you for your kind words, Alice.
Yes.
And hello, everyone. Of course, welcome to new subscriber to Alice Vibe channel. I hope that she will get a lot of supporters, a lot of love from all the dearest friends across the world. And of course, so let's start it over again. My name is Dante.
Yeah.
I'm studying the Business Fundamental Program at Computer System Institute. This is a very interesting program, a very great institute for everyone if they want to have a chance to explore themselves, to enhance their hidden talents. And today, I will participate in the questions that my dear friend Alice gave it to me. Now, we'll start it, okay?
Okay. The first question, Dante, what do you think about the educational system in the U.S.?
Let's just say one word only. The first, the only word I want to say is practical, which means real life experience. So over the years staying and studying in the United States, I realized that all the program, they give students a real life experience for them to look at and also to, how to say, to solve the problem. This is really interesting because you apply the theories from what you learn in a class into the real life situation.
Really? Just yes. Like we went out yesterday for the accounting class.
Yes,
and
that is.
We have
is.
To apply, you know, the credit and the debiting and the trial balance outside the classroom. And
yes.
That was such a practical lesson for our accounting class. That's amazing.
Yes.
Thank you. Let's go to the next question. Mm-hmm. What are some programs that you would advise our students out there to enroll in when they're in the United States?
What? So if you look at all the programs in the United States, they are all amazing. They have their unique features.
Yeah.
So however, in this couple of years, the number of nurses, they are requiring a lot of people studying nursing, healthcare, and especially those who are in the STEM field, which is short for science, technology, engineering, and mathematics. If you got a chance, try those one out. One of those out, they're really amazing. They got to give you opportunities and a lot of interesting job opportunities, and of course, salary is really interesting too.
So during those courses, it means upon graduation, you can easily grab a job that will help you to sustain your living in the United States, right?
It's sustaining is one part of the story. The
okay.
Second thing is how much confidence you will take, how much courage you will have. Yes.
Okay, great. Okay, the next question. Mm-hmm. As a student, are you permitted to study and work at the same time?
So working and studying, yes, technically yes, and there are like three categories, three types that you can look at. The first thing is the on-campus job. Everybody knows it. You find a job posted on the university or college portal, what job is opening, you apply there, and then you're gonna get an interview with the person in charge of that department. For
yes.
example, you work in, you want to, they're hiring a person doing the marketing, you talk with the person in charge of marketing in CSI campus, especially like this. Or, and there are also two other types, OBT, which is short for optional practical training. You do this after you graduated.
Oh, yeah.
That's why we also call it a post-completion a program.
Yeah.
You finish the program, you register, and you got the job.
You enroll.
You enroll as an intern for the company outside the campus.
Okay.
You work for like 40 hours per week maximum.
Okay.
CBT is like curricular practical training program.
Okay.
This is something that you do while you're still studying. So CBT is also very interesting, very beneficial, because the time that you're in class, the next day you go to work, you apply what you learn right into the work too.
Great.
And that is really interesting. You can choose between one of the two. But you have to notice that the time that you do CBT, you got 12 months from CBT. When you finish CBT, the time for OBT will be like deducted.
All right.
You spend like 6 months for CBT, so okay. Which means like 6 months left for OBT.
So it's preferable to go in for OBT.
OBT.
Oh,
yes.
Great. Thank you.
Yeah.
Let's go. Is it easy to get scholarship opportunity in the US as an international student?
Well,
and how?
Interesting. So yes, scholarship, they do. You go to some of the websites for US scholarship, you search it for the updated one. They do have that, and check carefully for each of the criteria. The scholarship, for example, the scholarship for young accountants, or scholarship for young businessmen, starters or something.
Yeah.
But you have to look carefully, because I know that getting a scholarship is a very competitive process.
It's true.
And you must look if they are for international students or not.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
And so of course there are possibility. So search for them, look for them, and of course, submitting them.
Yeah.
Take a leap of faith.
Yeah.
Take a leap of faith.
Be confident and just go for it.
Yeah.
Let's continue.
Yeah.
How about the rent and living expenses for students here?
Okay. Let's talk about only in Chicago downtown.
Okay.
Yes. So
because we are in Chicago right now.
It is. Yeah. It is. And yes, it's gonna be really pricey to look at some of the price and the process too. Yeah, like apartment list, apartment.com. Mm-hmm. These are the place that you usually go in there and look at it. But the process to get into the apartment, they give you something like credit score, social security number, even ask you how much you pay too. So that is something it will cost you quite amount of struggling when you're talking about that.
Okay.
So my advice is that you attend some of the Facebook group for some of the students that are coming from your country. For example, I'm originally from Vietnam.
Yes, so, and I'm from Cameroon.
Mm-hmm. So you can go to some of the Facebook group on Cameroon to look for that.
Yeah.
Every week or even twice a week, they will take some pictures like, oh, I need a roommate for two, but I need a roommate for one, and the price and everything. Search for that. That is considered to be a very simple, easiest way to talk about it.
Okay.
Not through any complicated leasing contract.
All right.
So that is the best advice. That is quite the best advice I can tell you.
Okay.
All right. And then if you look, and of course the price can be a little bit downer than you owning the entire apartment for your own.
So what can be the estimated price for a room downtown Chicago?
So this is my experience. Mm-hmm. So if anybody, you look outside, you look on the list, and the price changes, feel free to do so. My estimated price around Chicago is gonna be starting from $1,500 per month.
Okay.
That not include utilities like gas or Wi-Fi. Yeah.
All
right. Yeah, that is like the basic
price.
Yeah. Yeah.
The basic price.
So this can be more. This can be more when you're near like Michigan Avenue or near. Those are the things.
Mm-hmm.
I know that when you walk out Chicago a little bit,
in the county. In the suburb, that is where you can have a little bit cheaper. Yeah.
Yep.
But you still need the social security and the credit card before you can get the apartment. Right.
Yeah. So within the downtown, that process is going through a lot of requirements there too.
Yeah.
There was a time that person asked me that, okay, what is the credit score that you have or something like that. And at that time, I didn't. Back then I did not have that, so I'm kind of struggling to give them the answer.
We got it. Yeah. Yes, we are okay. Mm-hmm. Okay, now, what do you think about the cultural diversity here?
I just say they are very wonderful. In every corner of Chicago, you will find a lot of people. They come from different countries. Yes, so there is Mexican people, there's also people from Turkish.
Yeah.
All
even
the friends
in this class.
Yes, even in this class, I met Alice from Cameroon. That's really amazing, right?
And he's from Vietnam.
With one distance away. How do you say? It's only, I'm sitting next to a friend from Cameroon. And if you talk about geography, that's like distant away. This is amazing, right?
Yeah.
So you met wonderful people. Of course, you can learn new languages too.
Yeah.
And of course, at every corner, I know that there's like a different location that you can find your own food from your hometown.
Oh, yeah.
It's really amazing. Mm-hmm. So I bet if anyone wants to come to the United States, I'm sure that you get all these wonderful things. Cultural diversity,
yeah.
Richness in languages and everything.
Yeah. Yeah. That is it. Yeah. Great. And so let's continue. Is it easy for students to get a health insurance while in the U.S.?
Health insurance, yes, yeah. That is considered to be something that you have to have if you have been trouble with your a lot of accident and things. But for international students, I have to say, depending on the school you're applying to,
okay.
If you're studying PhD or master, you pay that low sum of money. Sorry, yeah. I should use tuition fees,
tuition,
not money. Yeah. That will include the health insurance within the tuition fee. Every year you pay the tuition fee, that includes the health insurance too.
Yeah.
But some of the college institutes, they don't cover that, and you have to go outside and figure out that one out.
Okay.
It's not easy. It is easy that you go online and you can find it. But you have to read carefully if this one is suitable for you and suitable for your budget as well.
Great.
Yeah.
Yes. Amazing. Okay. Is it for the transportation system, is it convenient for the students? Can they go their rounds throughout the country with convenient transportation system? Can you say something about that?
Yes. Public transportation, they are very common around the cities in Chicago, around the cities in different cities. Right within Chicago, we have the CTA Ventra public system,
yeah.
Subway and train system that is really easy for you to traveling around.
Yeah.
In other cities, they do have a bus system too, so we can move we can walk very easy
with a public system.
Yes.
Okay.
So I know that we as students is not but affording a car can be a little bit issue,
yeah.
For now, so take the maximum advantage of using the public transport. Okay, tell you a secret like now. So every public transport, like train or anything, they do have a limited price. Once every month,
yeah.
You pay a package with a certain amount of cash.
Mm-hmm.
You can get free. You can get like many rides as you can.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
So search for that.
Okay. Yeah. That's gonna help you.
Yes.
That's scary.
That's considered to be the transit pass.
And that would be more convenient to travel around the country.
Yes.
Yes. What's your tip on how to get a job off campus upon graduation?
So okay. Finding a job after your graduation, the first thing is very competitive. Yes. Because you are in a land of opportunities,
yeah.
But that also very concerned for you at first. My advice, first thing is never give up.
Okay.
Never give up. There are always places for you. There are always chances for you.
Yeah.
Maybe they don't accept your resume for the first time in this place. Okay, no worries. There's also other places.
Okay.
Go to some portal like Glassdoor, Indeed, LinkedIn. Yeah. These are the portals that you can find anywhere.
Yes.
You search for the one that you like.
Mm-hmm.
It's really good.
Yeah.
That is also the second thing, is that there are tools easy for you to use. You find it easily.
Yeah.
And then the third thing is always try to make your profile the beautiful,
the most one.
Yes, the most beautiful one of all.
Yeah.
You make them stand out so that you can get acceptance easier.
Okay.
Yes, those are the three tips I can actually share. I hope that this will be useful. All the questions that our friend Alice to give it to. Maybe it will be helpful. And I know that outside you have more opportunities, and I know that a lot of people, they have different lifestyles.
Yeah.
It's not judgmental, but I believe we can be access to you to pursue the dream in the United States.
Okay.
Yep.
So if you're out there and you really want to pursue your study in the United States, don't give up. It doesn't matter how many times you try to apply for a visa, and if you don't get it, don't give up on your dream. Keep trying, and when you get here, the opportunities are open. Please, can you throw more light on the weather? How about the weather in Chicago downtown?
So right now, today, it's gonna be a stormy night. It's gonna be a stormy day too. So, okay, prepare an umbrella. And of course, always try to go out, wear suitable clothes. So to cover, and of course, always protect yourself from any illnesses. And of course, more importantly, always enjoy yourself.
Okay.
If you step into the United States, it is a chance for you to enjoy different things. So be open-minded, try everything that you like. Okay?
And get connected to friends as well.
Of course.
Thank you so much, Dante. We are so grateful to have you on the channel today, and we hope, you know, all the advice that you've given, it will really be of great help to people out there, especially students who even have in you and they don't really know how to go about their study. So I think that this great advice is really, really helpful. And thank you so much, and we hope to have you more and more on this channel.
Of course. Thank you, Alice.
Yes.
And be sure to subscribe, to follow her channel, so that she can give more videos to you guys. Okay?
Yeah.
Thank you, everyone. Bye.
Yeah, say bye bye. You can say bye bye. Say bye bye. Bye bye.
Oh,
yeah.